Hi students, myself Neha Gupta, your mentor for current affairs, and I welcome you all in this series of morning tales which is helpful for your phase 1 of RBI, SEBI, NABARD and any other banking examination at the level of PO. So if this video is the first video that you are watching on our channel, then you should subscribe to our channel and hit this bell notification, guys, so that whenever we come live or we upload any new videos, you will get the instant updates. And as you must have seen on our channel that we have uploaded new videos for which are important for your RBI Grade B 2021 examination in the past, in this recent month only. So if you don't want to miss on the new videos, then you should subscribe and hit this bell notification, as well as you can join this Telegram group. And on this Telegram group, we will inform you about the new updates as well as we provide the quizzes. Also, if you have any kind of query related to the examination, then you can ask your mentors directly on this platform. So quickly join this group and the link is in description below. So guys, this is the new offering from our side. This is the crash course that we have launched for this year's examination. If you want to go for this course, then you can avail it at a 40% discount. And the code to avail that 40% discount is CRASH40. So whenever you try to buy this course, then you have to use this code in order to avail the discount, 40% discount. And this course is really helpful for your RBI Grade B preparation. If you have not prepared it earlier, and if you are planning to give the examination this year, which is in your March, phase 1 is in March and phase 2 is on the 1st April. So if you are planning to give the examination on such a short notice, then this course is definitely helpful for you in preparing your examination. Okay, chaliye, to ye, this is our first question of the day. Which state has signed an MOU with Confederation of Indian Industry to generate employment opportunities for the youth in the state? So we have Rajasthan, Madhya Pradesh, Himachal Pradesh, Goa and Kerala in the options, out of which the right answer is Goa. So under this MOU, basically the employment opportunities to the youngsters will be provided. And how this is going to be provided? Through the model career centers. Now you would be amazed to know this thing, that these model career centers are not a new concept. Regional Employment Exchange of Goa has been transformed into the model career centers. Basically, the Regional Employment Exchange has been remodeled with new infrastructure and a wide variety of responsibilities. Now, you should also know this thing, that this Confederation of Indian Industry already holds the responsibility of 39 model career centers across India. So it has established these model career centers at 39 different locations, and in the Goa one is the 40th model career center that CII has established to provide the employment to the youngsters. So all the information related to this news end here. Now my question from you is, the Chief Minister of Goa, that you have to tell me. Goa se related, there is one special and the most important project also that we have discussed in the recent past, and that project is, I hope that you can remember, India's first convergence project in the renewable energy sector. So that too is going to be in Goa. That is the thing that you have to remember. Next question. With which country did India conduct its first meeting of the joint working group in the field of renewable energy? So basically, a meeting of the joint working group has been held in the field of renewable energy for the first time by India with a country. So which country is it? We have France, Norway, UAE, Saudi Arabia and Bahrain in the options, out of which the right option is option E, Bahrain. So with this country, India has conducted its first ever joint working group meeting in the renewable energy sector. And guys, in the year 2018, India and Bahrain have signed an MOU by virtue of which these two countries have to collaborate in the field of renewable energy. So this is something that you should be aware of, that the MOU for cooperation in the renewable energy between India and Bahrain was signed in 2018, and the first joint working group meeting was held in the year 2021. So that's all for this question, but my question from you is the capital and currency of Bahrain. Tell me in the comment section below. So now we are on a state scheme. Which state UT has approved Mukhya Mantri Vigyan Pratibha Pariksha, in which rupees 5,000 will be provided to 1,000 meritorious students of class 9th in schools as a science scholarship? So we have Delhi, Jammu and Kashmir, Karnataka, Lakshadweep and Puducherry in the options. Which one is the right answer? The right answer is Delhi. So it's Delhi government that has announced this Mukhya Mantri Vigyan Pratibha Pariksha. So this is basically an examination. After qualifying this examination, the students of class 9th will get a scholarship of rupees 5,000. And what is the purpose of conducting this examination? The purpose is to increase or arouse the interest of students in the science field. So this is the basic purpose, and the name itself is also suggesting this. Vigyan is science, Pratibha is the caliber, or is the Pratibha is the ability. So in order to increase the capability of students towards the science, in the science sector, as well as to increase their interest in that sector, this examination has been launched by the government of Delhi. What is the theme of World Sustainable Development Summit 2021? So we have five themes: redefining our common future, safe and secure environment for all, towards 2030 goals, making the decade count, clean oceans, climate finance, energy transition, sustainable agriculture and mobility, partnership for a resilient plane, beyond 2020, people, planet and progress. So out of these five options, the right theme is option A, redefining our common future, safe and secure environment for all. This is the theme of 2021 World Sustainable Development Summit. Now guys, which country organizes this World Sustainable Development Summit? It is India. And this is the 20th edition of this summit, organized by the TERI. So TERI stands for the Energy Research Institute. So this TERI organizes this summit annually, and the purpose of this summit is to have a conversation and knowledge sharing practice in the field of sustainable development, so that the goals of sustainable development can be achieved. So that is all for this question. The things that you have to remember are right in front of you: the theme, the edition, the company or the organization conducting or organizing this World Sustainable Development Summit 2021. So that's all guys for this question. My question from you is the chief of TERI. You have to mention who is the present chief of this organization. Next question is, which country will develop world's first energy island? Now what is this energy island? This thing is a very unique initiative taken by a country. I will tell you the details of this island a little later, but first let's discuss the answer of this question. So which country is it that has announced to develop the world's first energy island? Or I should reframe my sentence, that which country is this that has already begun the work on this first energy island? So we have UK, USA, Japan, Spain and Denmark in the options. Which country is it? It's Denmark. So this Denmark has announced to develop this, or is developing this, world's first energy island in the North Sea. Now, what is this energy island? Basically, energy island is an artificial island, and the mechanism of this energy island will be greatly elaborated to you, will be greatly comprehensive to you through this picture. So guys, this is the island which will be developed by Denmark. And through this island, basically, these are the offshore wind turbines. So if you remember that I have told you what is the offshore wind power plant and what is the offshore wind energy. So offshore wind turbines or the power plants are those which are located in the water bodies like oceans or seas. So this reminds me to ask you that which country is developing the offshore world's largest offshore wind power complex? I have recently covered this question, guys. Therefore, I expect you to answer this question in the comment section below. Now, let's come back to this question. So, this is the artificial island and this is the North Sea. So, this is basically the structure of this island that is going to be developed by Denmark. Now, through these are the wind turbines and offshore wind turbines, and the energy of these offshore wind turbines will be collected through this island, and through this collected energy, or we can say this collected green energy, will be transferred to the European island to supply the electricity, to supply the energy to the households. Approximately 3 million households will be supplied electricity through this artificial island. And you will be amazed to know this thing, that the size of this island is as great as that it can subsume 18 football fields into it. Now, this fact is not very important for you to remember. It's just a basic fact that I wanted to tell you, that it is a very great island that is being developed by Denmark. So that's all. I hope that you can easily understand what this island is and what will it do. It will supply the green energy to European households and the shipping industry. So it will also provide energy to the ships. That is the whole purpose of this artificial island. And remember that it is for world's first energy island that is being developed. Now guys, we have one other option in the in this question, and that is Spain. So do you know that what is so special about Spain, specifically if we talk about the renewable energy? If you know this question, then do tell me in the comment section below, why have I highlighted Spain? Remember that it is doing something great in the solar energy sector. Now I have given you the hint. Tell me the answer in the comment section below. Next question is, who has been appointed as the chairman of National Safety Council? Anil Yadav, B.N. Bhaskar, Gurdeep Singh, Amrish Sharma, and we have S.N. Subramaniam. So which one is the right answer? The right answer is option E. S.N. Subramaniam is the new chairman of National Safety Council, who has released the book Parliamentary Messenger in Gujarat, or basically who has authored this book. So you have Vinod Kumar, K.N. Bhandari, Astik Sinha, Gaurav Shukla, Suraj Prakash Sharmam. Out of these options, it is option B, K.N. Bhandari, who has written this Parliamentary Messenger in Rajasthan book. And why this book is important, the reason behind this is Vice President of India, that is Venkaiah Naidu, launched this book himself. Therefore, this book is very important for your examination. So here guys, I would like to end this session. If you have any queries related to the questions that I have told you in this video, then you can ask me in the comment section below. Thank you so much for watching this session.